Hello friends, now I explain the four levels of the project. Actually, in the previous video, I explained the problem and the probable solution, the formatted output. Actually, when you are writing examination, how is your behavior? First, you understand the question thoroughly. After understanding the question thoroughly, what you do? Which answer I have to produce with a reference to that question? This thing. That two phases are over. After this thinking process is over, then you start writing on the paper. That is implementation. Okay. First, you have to understand. In a project or program development process, these are the stages. You have to gradually understand. Okay. Actually, whenever a project is given to a college student, most students are terrified because it's too big. How can they do that? Then, here, I am providing you a different environment. We are also taking up a good project. On the day one of your study of this program, you are developing 100 plus lines project. But don't worry about that. It is unlike your formal studies. Here, I am dividing it in four levels. Now, first level contributes 50% for the second level. Second level contributes 75% approximately for the third level. And third level contributes 90% for the fourth level. So, for the sake of distinction, what we do? PFT 1A, 1B, 1C, 1D. Names are very important because we are going to perform tens of programs, 100 plus programs we are going to do. That's why every time you maintain this name. If you have any better idea, you do that. I don't discourage, but this is a basic norm. Otherwise, hundreds of projects are there with you. You are confused. Okay. Then, this is the way I am providing you the project. You need not terrify. The last PFT 1D, I give you an assignment. By that 90% you complete under my guidance. Thereafter 10% if you add, then wonderful project, 100 plus lines project you are going to develop. That's why I am telling you, it will remain as a milestone in your programming studies. Now I explain PFT 1A. This is already task I explained. This is simple sequential program. A set of statements, simply you write a set of statements without using any functions. However, by that you understand the problem. You understand what is input, what is process, what is output, everything you understand. Okay. That means 50% of the main task you learnt. Thereafter, 1B. 1B is the function-oriented program. That means you take up the same task and you write that program as a function-oriented program. In order to write a function-oriented program, what you have to do? This is the main task. The main task should be divided into sub-tasks like this. In order to perform each such sub-task, you have to define a function. For that purpose, you should have command over functions. The relevant concepts I am going to give you. Just a matter of 1 hour you study them, then you will be perfect over functions. Then only you write function-oriented program. Okay, that is the second level. Second level, first level, whatever you learned, PFT 1A, that contribute not less than 50% for the PFT 1B. That point you have to understand and proceed. Okay, PFT 1C, that third level. I am adding few more functionalities which are implemented in real life. Gradually, you have to understand what is going on in real life. So, now, you prepared a statement which displaying the areas of the room in a formation. Now, I am giving you a task of renovation. Renovation means you are replacing the floor tiles and repainting the room. Those are the tasks. So, what are the costs and all that I give you. So, replacing the floor means you have to take a floor area. Repainting the room means which areas you paint? You paint for four walls area minus the total area of the doors and windows. This is the common sense. Okay, thereafter ceiling also is included. So you have to calculate the cost of that. That cost details and all that I give, and you have to prepare one more statement for renovation cost. Renovation cost statement includes cost of renovation of flooring, replacing flooring, cost of renovation of the walls. Walls means four walls area minus the total area of doors and windows plus ceiling. That point. In this way, in real life, what is going on, you can understand. Thereafter, 1D. This is the fourth level. In the fourth level, one more functionality I am adding for renovation. What is that? What we have excluded in 1C? We have excluded the painting of doors and windows. Actually, that cost is different. That is cost is little higher than painting of walls. This is common sense. You must understand that. Then, that cost also you include in the renovation cost statement. That is the assignment for you. That is just 5% or 10% of the entire task you have to perform. But at the end, if you develop a project, then you think differently. You experience the sense of achievement. That I cannot explain. You experience that. In this way, four levels of programs we give. First one only is sequential program. Remaining three are function-oriented program. So, by performing this project, you will be perfect over functions and many other things. I need not explain because you are going to perform this today itself. Whenever you start, on the very day, you can complete it.